July 1967, Detroit, Michigan experienced one of the worst race riots in American history. The week-long riot killed 42 people, demolished 2,000 buildings, and destroyed the psyche of a once great city that has never recovered. That same year, Detroit Pershing High School, led by legendary coach Will Robinson and future NBA All-Star Spencer Haywood and Ralph Simpson, won the first of the school's record 5 Class A state championships.
Kendall, the takeaway on the ball by Dinsu. The dish for Affleck. Oh, they can roll and the record book. Unbelievable effort in this game for Dean Affleck. 49 points. Welcome to the record books. And welcome to a Class A title. It's on the board now here in Brentwood, and they are applauding.
During that time period, the Doughboys have also won 7 city titles, along with developing several professional and collegiate players.
Doughboys! Now the 1996 PSL champions!
Places where people look at and say, you know, they have great basketball players. What I think Steve did to it is say they have great people that also can play basketball. Steve Smith has been definitely one of the highlights of Michigan State and has got to be one of the most important alums that left Pershing High School.
Pershing High School is kind of the pride of Detroit when it comes to basketball. The great Will Robinson, his coaching legacy speaks for itself.
So it's very significant in terms of Detroit. The coaches had been well aware of the fact that they'd been out of state competition, it seemed like forever. So it was Pershing State Championship, it was the first time the DPS and they all came together.
So many people over the years I saw who would walk up to him or come up to me even and say, hey, you know, I played for Coach Robinson when I was at Pershing. And just so many guys And they all had the same story about what a profound impact he had on their lives as young kids growing up.
He was truly a pioneer to get that opportunity at Illinois State and having the best player even to this day to ever play there, being a white gentleman in Doug Collins, their star player. And I can remember Doug Collins referring to Coach Robinson throughout his career as a pro coach and as a commentator. He always paid his respect. And you know what Collins was. I mean, he's an all-star, he's an Olympian, and an all-American.
Doug will tell you that he's responsible for learning how to play the game and all of that career he had afterward. You know, he went to the Olympics, you know, actually made the foul shots he should have done. All that comes back to Illinois State. He saw Rodman and Sally and recommended him. Joe Dumars is probably the best example. His quote was, and Bad was known for, when he came back, I think he went down to see a tournament, I think that's what it was, and I think McNeese State was playing, and I don't even think he was there to see Joe as such, but he saw Joe and he came back and said to the general manager, McCloskey, and Isaiah, his way he said it, I've seen the other guard, meaning the shooting guard we need. And they had already made up their mind to draft some All-American, I can't remember who it was, they made up their mind. And he argued and fought, this is a better kid, this is a better fit. And you know, the rest is history. Isaiah and Dad were extremely close, probably as close as any. And that's not because of comedy, just had that kind of relationship. We used to run Isaiah's camp. When Isaiah came here, Isaiah said, Will Robinson has never lied to me about anything I needed to know. So they were just where it was one of those relationships that players had with other folks.
You got to have good discipline with yourself. You need to get all the education you can. You have to have a strong sense of humility. Last but not least, you got to be an honest person. You got to be honest in your dealing with other people.
If you ever had a chance to spend any time with this guy, you would understand what special means when you talk about Will Robinson.
From 1985 through 1999, the late Johnny Gostin oversaw the program's most successful tenure, winning consecutive state and city titles from 1992 through 1995. Gostin also developed a host of professional and collegiate players like Steve Smith, and the school's first Mr. Basketball and McDonald's All-Americans in Willie Mitchell and Winfred Walton.
.42% and Todd Bergen with
Willie Mitchell with the steal, and Willie ain't going to give it off to anyone. He just winds it up and jams it home. He led all scorers with 21. 25 at the half was their lead. And then the Doughboys one more time. Bergen with the steal to Keith Tate to Robert Tillman for the big jam.
When you go to a Doughboys game, I mean, it's going to be action-packed. An exciting brand of basketball, and they've always been competitive.
Beaten Wall Lake Central, Willie Mitchell with this emphatic statement coming up for you. The Doughboys were too quick for the Vikings. Carlos Williams showing some style on that reverse jam. Williams proved just as adept on defense. Here with a steal over to Todd Bergen, back to Williams for the power jam, and Pershing led by 21 at the half. They go on for the easy victory.
Oh, they enjoy what they're doing. I think, you know, that's what I tell them every day, just have fun. If you take that approach, just play just like you play every day, and not concentrate on anything else, but having fun and playing hard. Play as hard as you possibly can, and let the chips fall where they may.
Johnny was, he wasn't a coach, he was a father. He was like a dad to everybody. You know, it was more than just coaching. He gave you so much, you know. I mean, like right now, I just, you know, told my girls, you know, because I coach the girls, I just told them that was a father to me. You know, he goes the extra mile. You know, he teach you about life. It's more than basketball, you know. So, I mean, if you down, he pick you up, you know. If you didn't have nothing to eat, he bring you something to eat, you know. If you needed something for school, he get that, you know. So, and then he had us so tight-knitted, you know, as far as the brothers, because we all brothers now. I mean, right now, I mean, Cahill Felder, Steve Smith, Dewan Sewell, Lorenzo, all of us keep in touch up until this day.
Pershing, ranked number one, they have some terrific players. Jay Berry has more on this year's Doughboys.
You're playing the top-ranked Pershing Doughboys, and the best I can give you is a heartfelt good luck, because you're going to need it. Their speed should be against the law. They hit zone-busting threes with regularity, and the way they intimidate is definitely a factor in the outcome. Granted, Southeastern has had better teams, but then again, playing Pershing in the 90s has yielded little relief for opponents, regardless of who they are.
Court here on Northern at Ferndale, Thurian Richard, thank you very much. 6'7 sophomore Willie Mitchell on the receiving end of this half-court alley-oop as Pershing pads its lead, and later Richard being pulled down by one of the Huskies. Dunks anyway, there's the final, 73-39.
People in the city are proud of Pershing. They're proud of what they've done and how they carry themselves. There really hasn't been, in my recollection, any bad incidents of a Pershing team at a certain event. I mean, they carry themselves well. A.W. and Johnny Goston, you go through the rest of the program, back to Will Robinson. And you look at Willie Mitchell and how he stays in the community, and Deshaun Sims graduating from U of M. And it really is a continuation of perhaps what Will started, but Johnny revived.
Pershing's like a Kentucky, you know, of high school basketball. You know, every year, the fans and the community expect you to be playing for the championship, no matter what it is, you know. And anything else, you know, is not acceptable, you know what I'm saying? So, to me, that sets the standard, you know, and it's a headstone for us to look in that direction and say that's the direction we want to head towards.
Point of what I'm telling y'all, fellas, it's time. It's time to get better. If you want to get better, then it ain't no better place. But I'm telling you, if you're not taking it serious, then again, whatever you take for a joke is going to do what to you? Can't hear y'all. Take you for a joke, man. Don't play around with this game, man. No, it can take you a long way, especially with a free education.
But when you come here, it just seems like you're entrenched in the thought of, I want to win. I want to represent this blue and gold with all my heart, all my soul.
Let's go. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it. Spread it.
Wait, dude.
Come on. Kadazi right there with you. Push, Juwan. Push. Push.
Come on, Keith. Get there. Come on, Keith. Get there.
Hey, you better not let him catch you. Let's go. Come on, Vontae. Putting on the
place, bro. I mean, it's no secret. We instill discipline. You know, the kids are held to a certain standard, and they can't fall below that standard. And each one, no matter who you are, you're held to that same standard.
what Coach Canada has done is really built on a tradition. He teaches the game. Nothing's changed. He has respect of the coaches in the city, the respect of his kids. He has his kids in there working in the morning, and you know, with an organized program, and after school, they get after it in practice. He's taken his team to you know, different camps. He's a student of the game, and they're very fortunate to have him because he can coach at the next level.
He will put in as many hours as necessary to get the children academically sound, athletically sound. He builds teamship. He builds camaraderie. He shows dedication and commitment. He goes beyond the call of duty with the children, tutoring, and more like a father figure to them.
Got one. Go.
I gotta make this short.
But it ain't no contact though.
Okay, I thought it was.
No. That's what I mean. You sitting here talking. I would have told you it was a good call. Telling you this, if you complaining about playing time, take our stuff home and go. Don't act stupid. See, the difference is, and that's why I love Brandon Perry to death. Sit down. It's a gift for your ass to be with the team. You, don't say nothing. We got more confidence in y'all than y'all got in yourself. It's just a selfish vibe, man. Everybody worried about them. Everybody worried about themselves. F y'all, F me. It's about the P. If you ain't feeling that, get the hell on. That goes for anybody, 1 through 12. We don't have no prima donnas, man. We don't have no superstars. Everybody is a star here. All of us, coaches and players included, we all stars. It's just some nights, some guys stars shine bright. That's it. Hey, one. Devontae, on that press breaker, come all the way up.
Take it out, drag over the half.
You want you down. Hold on, you taking it out?
Yeah, I'm gonna take it out. Drag
okay, go ahead. Middle. The back, 23.
Couple things. It's gonna be games like that on the road. Every game not gonna be a blowout. It's gonna be games where you gotta fight. You gotta pull everything you got. We was trailing three whole straight quarters, and y'all stayed together. Y'all never quit. Not saying it's a championship team in this locker room, but that's the sign of a champion that never quits.
Congratulations to our 2001
can't talk about it, you got to be about it. I will say this, we have came too far. Ain't nobody worked as hard as we work. Nobody do the things that we do. Nobody. So go out there, have fun, respect your opponent, close out on every shot, steal the ball if you can every time, rebound the ball every time if you can, do those things well, and we'll be successful. Because it's March. And we can't keep stressing it. In March, teams go down. The best team will always win. We don't talk about opponents. They have nothing to lose. Their championship will be sitting Pershing home.
Four.